Good morning and thank you very much for joining us. I am Yori Folari. This morning, I'm starting off with Mr. Dennis Amakre, MON, former assistant director, DSS, and security consultant. Thank you very much for coming, as always, Dennis.
Good morning, Yori.
Indeed. You got something of a cold, but we will manage.
We will manage.
Now, not very much to laugh about because we look at the security situation. Let's continue on that theme. This is where we were yesterday. And I don't know, depends on how you look at it, but there are, it also depends on where you are. But let's say the South East, generally, that seems to be tough. As you know, we started off the week being able to talk about the dastardly murder of Gulak. Of course, the presidency had said at the time that we will deploy everything at our disposal to get into the bottom of this. And then we're hearing in very short order that the police have been making some sort of headway. Newspaper reports are saying that police nab Gulak's killers, which you look at the headline alone, you say, oh, that's good because now we'll be able to get to the bottom of this. Who sent you? Who are you? And all of that. But then we're hearing that, if I'm reading it right, there might be no survivors of that clash confrontation with the police. You've also been hearing all of this. What can you make out of all of this, Dennis?
Yeah, really, I'm very, very worried. I'm very, very worried because as an investigator, you know, if we had that opportunity to track down these guys somewhere, whether they were sharing onions or whatever they are doing, and then we got about, from the number, about 6 or 9 of them, there is no reason to kill all of them. You know, because there is a major issue where somebody has been assassinated, because this is not just murder or just a random shooting. It's an assassination of an important high-profile politician. So we should have at least arrested some people and interrogate them as to what happened and who was behind all the shooting.
You know, we were scheduled to be able to take on a police officer this morning, the police PPPRO in Imo State, but it wasn't, let's just put it discreetly, it was overtaken by certain events. I'm not even sure what those events are, but the message we just got, because I would have wanted to go straight to Imo State Police Command and hear from them, but it wasn't possible anymore. Now, therein is a challenge, because I don't know that we can, the extent to which we can believe newspaper reports. Because if we had been able to speak with the police, I'd have tried to check this with the police.
Yes.
But so right now, all of these stories that we're hearing that police nabbed them and that police might actually have killed all of them, I don't know. As you were saying, you said you're very concerned. It doesn't sound like the kind of, like the police work that we understand. Because how are you going to investigate it?
How can you investigate it? And how do you know that those people are really the people that killed the politician? You know, you've killed all of them. Did you interrogate them to find out who among them was among those who killed him? So you cannot say that, okay, you pursued some cars. Some cars were mentioned, Lexus and a Hilux and, you know, another car. Where are the cars? They should have shown
and
us
there
those
were no
cars.
Pictures. There were no photographs.
There
are
no pictures,
you know,
nothing. So nothing. I think the police have a lot to explain on this because it is very, very saddening.
Well, they swung into action following the statement from the presidency that everything that is possible will be done to get to the bottom of this. So I don't know. The police wouldn't move in that sort of a knee-jerk reaction. These are trained people, I'm imagining.
Yeah.
They are trained investigators. So why would you see a cache of possible suspects
and destroy the evidence?
And then, but they did say, what do you think, Dennis? Maybe they didn't go out wanting to wipe out all the suspects, but if they were attacked, and they became a firefight, did the police have very much options? Did they have any other option? Maybe that's one simplistic way to look at it.
There is no way you can just kill everybody.
I see.
Because there is no way. Some will be wounded. And then, of course, you know, you can go up to them and then, of course, give a second shot or something to silence them.
Yeah,
it'd be. But
if If you have a plan where you want to still keep people alive.
Yes, in fact, with your with this mindset that you're going to take some people alive,
mm-hmm.
you know, then you go in there and make sure that some are alive to give you some information, vital information.
Okay, we have the governor of Imo, Hope Uzodinma. I think this was very, very recently, maybe yesterday. He was definite about it, that this is a political killing. Wasn't very much news.
Most
people would have expected that, but let's hear the governor.
Elijah Mel Gulak was in Imo State for a national assignment. He came to Owerri with the Senate Committee on Constitutional Amendment. Someone must have trailed him from his hotel to the airport. That is exactly why this gruesome murder appears to be a clear case of political assassination. Let me make it very clear that everything will be done by security agencies to find those who murdered Gulak.
Okay, they took it away too early, but we heard the last few words off picture, something like
that. He was actually there for the Senate committee, you know, but even then, I thought that there will be some kind of security escort. They will be moving together. So why did he take a cab? I was moving alone to the airport. You know,
and as we heard, via what has been referred to as an unusual route.
Unusual route, why all that?
And it was also said that he didn't ask for police escort. Which I imagine that protocol would have been a courtesy, you know.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying. Why is he not moving a group? Or was he rushing out for an emergency to catch a plane to get out of the state? Or what? What was the problem? You know, so these are all things. And even those people that were in the car with him, you know, we need to...
They were not harmed.
But we don't know who they are.
We don't know who they are. He wasn't the only person in the car.
Yeah.
So it reminds me of an old song, there are more questions than answers. You know, all of these questions. So maybe it's about time that the police sort of address the public.
Yes, they should. They should address the public and then, of course, do more investigation into all this, because there are too many questions to be answered.
And this is the truth that is, and it doesn't really do anything to instill a sense of calm. They might say be calm, be going about your business, but it's so foggy out there. Meanwhile, other people are issuing travel risk advisories. They're warning, you know, Nigerians,
of course,
to stay away from certain areas that are thought to be hotspots. Even in our environment here, I think in Ogun State, they said, you know, that some communities there are actually now moving into Benin Republic. In Lagos here, they say watch out for Badagry and Ikorodu, which is not the same as to say that there's any problem, you know, there now. But they are saying that
no serious problem right now. Mm-hmm. But you know, people are worried.
And people have to be security conscious.
People are really worried that they have to be security conscious about where they're going. And then, of course, just watch what they are doing right now.
Yeah. Okay. Mr. Garba in Makurdi, good morning.
Good morning, Uncle Yori.
Thank you very much for calling.
You guys are doing fantastic job. Honestly, I appreciate what you are doing. Like, what do you guys think? The police have a lot of questions to answer. Because I expect the police should carry a kind of thorough investigation before they come out and say they killed or did not kill, whatever they said. I believe that Nigeria, they all Nigeria is a nation. And secondly, I want to call on Nigeria. We should distinct from spreading rumors and fake news. Look at what happened in major states. The registrar of Mako. Some people come out say that he was assassinated. Whereas he died of heart attack, shockingly, in the channel there, Mario, called a security expert from Imo State, he alluded to that. He said he was affected. Whereas it's wrong. Things are much more Nigeria at this juncture. Mm-hmm. When we need anything that will promote peace in this country.
Exactly.
Rumor and fake news, all substantial information, you come on media or on air and the thing is half a nice day over here.
Thank you very much for calling in, Garba. It's a murky environment in terms of personal safety, the way you feel about personal safety. It has become a murky environment, and quite frankly, it was unnecessary because the police could have taken charge from the very, very beginning. I don't know where all these stories are coming from, and as soon as the police see that there are stories that are not issued from them, that they have not put out, they perhaps ought to have spoken, even though it's very, very recent. You know, it's only Monday that we started talking about this whole matter. Now, that same Monday, the event haven't happened earlier. The police are saying that they haven't spoken to us, so we are not able to say the police are saying. But we're just going by newspaper reports. And the way the police is handling it, perhaps it can be done better so that people get a different sense of security. Or is it the case that we are sort of almost like helpless?
No, that's not it. I think the police can do a better job in dealing with this by actually investigating, even now. This thing has happened for more than 24 hours now. So the true version should be out by now. The police should be able to come out, hold a press conference, and tell people this is actually what happened.
And take questions.
Take questions.
Although we understand that they can't probably tell us everything. The police know what they keep within.
Yes.
But they also know the stuff to put out there so that all these social media messages flying around, you can put them in the right context.
Because
you
have about three different versions of what happened.
Exactly.
You know, there's no need for that. We should have one version from the police.
Mr. Emmanuel in Abuja, good morning.
Yeah, good morning.
Go right ahead, please.
All right. I just go back to... good morning. I'm so happy to see you talking about this, discussing about the issue in Nigeria pertaining to the insecurities. I just go back to Abuja this morning. The things I'm seeing in Owerri, it's not making sense at all. Hope Uzomahima has really failed everybody in Imo State and all the Igbos in general. I remember when this man came for campaign in particular place in Osun local government in Awoedemili. People blocked him. They said that they are not supporting, they won't support you. But with the way they are seeing you, you're coming to shed blood in Imo State. He said, if you bring your body now, they will shed your own blood. This will happen in Imo State or local government. I said, sir, listen to what they are saying. Promise them, wish them well. He said that they should arrest the three of us. I said, for what? The moment he wanted to leave, he came with the wife and his son, non-tall boy, Obina, with security agency. They blocked the road. They didn't allow him go. I said, sir, try your best for these people. Let them go. In fact, no, a lot of blood. I don't know what to say again. But Buhari is aware of all these things. You can know how Hope Uzodinma came as governor in Imo State because he accepted to offer what Buhari wants.
I don't want us to go there. I just want us to stay with the facts that, there are a lot of people who are sore about, you know, the Supreme Court aspect of Governor Uzodinma's, being in place. And one can understand that. But should we just leave it at the facts? But thank you very much, Emmanuel, for your call, nevertheless. Spoke about, you know, coming in from from Owerri in particular. Yeah. And that's one of the states where there was a complete lockdown. There was a complete lockdown. And you begin to wonder who actually is in charge. A proscribed organization is given a different, kind of indication. The authorities, I was hearing with the governor of Rivers saying that there can be no such nonsense here. It's not going to happen in Rivers, kind of a thing.
So Rivers is not part of the Southeast. Rivers is South-South.
Good morning, Ada, in Jos.
Yeah, good morning, Mr. Yori.
Good morning, madam.
Makri.
Good morning.
Yes, good morning. Ada from Jos. No matter what it is, I don't think it is right to, assassinate anybody.
Exactly.
It's really unfortunate, honestly speaking. But then what I don't understand is why did the policemen, why did they kill all of them?
Exactly.
You know, we have a clumsy way of doing investigation. So when you all of them are dead,
well, if that is indeed a fact, but unfortunately the police are not ready to speak with us. We wanted to clear that up.
That's what I'm saying. Now, that's why they always give room for all, you know, speculation, people talking what they like, and social media, they are coming with all kinds of fake news because the real news is not there. Then another thing is, I watched a program on Sunrise Daily, you know, I think it is channels or what, and a friend of his said on that day that they blocked all the usual routes, but he didn't know why. So the driver that took him to the airport had to take an unusual route as well. So I begin to wonder, if there was something like that, why didn't they let them look? You know, so I don't understand what's happening in Nigeria. You know, up to today, when the Korea election happened, I remember very well, I called into a police diary. The police population force, he also told us that those were fake police. And I said, can you tell us who are the first fake police? They could not tell us. Up to today, they have not told us. So what's happening in Nigeria? You know, you see, that my worry now is that even if they have shot them, even if they shot all of them dead, they have not got to the bottom of it. If you allow the people who actually sponsored them to go free, we have not achieved anything. That's my worry now.
Yeah.
And then I feel dialogue is the best way to go. Mr. Makri, I don't know if you have that in mind too. I believe this idea of militarizing place has not helped matters. The villagers don't buy in. Even the IPOB station at home. My people call me and said, they're not sitting at home because of IPOB. They're not even staying in the hands of the security people they sent there. That was why they sent back at home. They're not sure the government. The government cannot protect them. So what are we talking about?
Okay.
It's really unfortunate. Let's not give up on this country.
Thank you very much for calling in. She wanted your opinion on the whole matter, on her thought that, look, dialogue perhaps is going to be beneficial to us here. But do you dialogue with people who are actually bordering on secession or sedition and all of those kind of things?
It has always been the end product of any insurgency or even terrorist groups. You know, by the end of the whole thing, you find out that all the parties concerned will come to the table.
Yes.
And talk.
Yeah.
Because United Nations, Israeli, Palestinian, all kinds of things, you know, all these kind of groups that are against each other, at the end of the day, they come and sit down and talk. So, in the case of Nigeria, you find out that many people are still questioning that document that brought us together, that amalgamated us, and felt that maybe that document has expired. You know, so there is need for people to come and sit down and talk about it again.
Because it wasn't you, but it was someone else. I'm sure you have also heard the idea that apparently some American general is said to have said to a president at the time that, yes, Mr. President, we're not going to be able to shoot our way out of this problem.
Yes.
We're going to have to die.
No, it's not going to be a military thing. Because people have to talk themselves. We have to sit down and talk about it.
Mazi Okorafor, good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, Amakari.
Yeah. Good morning.
How is Aruchukwu, by the way, in the light of everything going on?
Yes.
Aruchukwu, we are former assistants officials, so Aruchukwu is even far from the capital of Abia State, Umuahia. So that not, we prefer coming to Akwa Ibom or Cross River, because that place is closer to us.
Yeah.
Now, the matters arising on the issue, like say, there are two things that place in anything that has to do with assassination. You don't need any concern. This is what you call strategic management theory. Two things that plays in terms of assassination. One, power. Two, money. These two things, when you're talking about assassination of an individual into any business or any form of killings in strategic management, it has to do either power or money. Now, you have to accept these two things, is Nigerian government looking or not? Now, if you look at issue of assassination, go down to Afghanistan or Iraq. Look at what happened there in Iraq or Afghanistan when Americans came into the issue of political elites and among themselves. Now you have Mr. Yuri and this Mr. Makri. Mr. Makri, at least part of, we want to know that River State is also part of Eastern Nigeria. today, tomorrow, or the next day. Whether we like it or not, Rivers is also under Eastern Nigeria. That's the Ukraine, Eastern Nigeria. Let's keep that one aside. Let's talk about issue of statement. Now, for we to leave this issue of assassination, this has been going on since, but because of breakers, they will be going on Nigeria, that reduced that. It can now surface, bringing back what happened. Look, if you go to Afghanistan, somebody will come now, we are going into the business. And we are going to a business, we have a deal between me and Mr. Amakre and Mr. Yuri is not part of the business. Mr. Amakre, we have a deal. Now, this deal, we agree that we are going to do this. Mm-hmm. At the end of the day, what are we supposed to do? We follow the sequence. But if it's a way by want to play smart, it comes back. Now, what are we going to learn from this issue? Nigerian people should stop this issue of politics of money and the rest. Because dividends of democracy is to do exactly what you agreed to do for the people. But the situation whereby we turn politics in Nigeria into Afghanistan system or Iraqi system is not healthy. Because the youth behind, they are learning. By the time the youth in Nigeria will copy that system, now what will happen in the future? That means there is no Nigeria. But everybody should know that we have no other country except this country. No matter whatever, if you like, go to Ghana or Cotonou here, even Cotonou, there is, look, walk into Cotonou today from Lagos. There are plenty of enter to Cotonou. If you don't have it, they will take you to the police will arrest you. Before you stop, they will take you to the court. Before they are treated, before they will release you, good. But the question, we take this for granted. We have a break. No matter whatever anybody shows in this country, you must repeat. If
okay, Mazi.
You must repeat.
All right. Thank you very much for calling in.
Yeah.
I would dare say that just, in fact, some social media messages I don't even open anymore.
Yeah.
When you just see the color of this one, well, it's not helpful. You delete because yeah, so much fake news. And yeah. Unfortunately, it is swirling around and forming impressions in people's minds. And what we actually need is the truth. We need to know the extent of the challenge. Nobody is saying it's light. It is indeed dire.
Yeah.
But people now go beyond the pale just because it's like creative writing.
Yes.
And unfortunately, in a situation such as we are talking about, this political assassination, that's what I'm calling it, of Mr. Gulak, we don't even have clarity on that. Yeah. The governor has said, we just said that, yeah, it's political. And I'm talking about political killings. Well, while this is being investigated, it won't be the first. There have been political killings in the past.
Yeah.
But now that it is mixing up with, kidnap for ransom.
Mm-hmm.
People are now distinguishing between terrorists and bandits.
Yes.
So the whole place is now mixed up.
Smuggled up.
And meanwhile, we haven't heard from Mr. President at all. Of course, I know there are those who will say that. What do you want Mr. President to say? People are speaking for Mr. President.
Yeah.
Well, there's a psychological aspect to this thing.
No, I think besides the president hearing from him, you know, we should be hearing from the local government chairman and the governors, you know. At least the governor has said something. But we need to hear from the local government
mm-hmm.
chairman where this is happening. They exist.
They exist.
They collect money every month.
But they are quiet.
They are quiet, doing nothing. I don't understand it because are they saying that the government does not cover that area? There are several as of the four of them in this country. And they are behaving as
so
if
what role
nothing.
Are they playing?
That's the point. They are just wasting our money.
Let me hear from Mr. Sunday, who has called in from Ewekoro. Good morning, Mr. Sunday.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah.
Mr. Yori, sorry, I'm a young guy. I wanted to ask one question. I know we are having problems in this country. Everybody knows that. But the question is, those who are being killed, is there any way we are going to save them after Nigeria is come back to his to our own, you know, stable condition? If the answer is no, why are we killing ourselves? Is that going to solve the problem we are having at hand? Why killing will be the solution to the issue we are having? That is number one.
I beg your pardon. I'm not going to be able to take beyond that number one simply because of time constraints. I'm so sorry. You can call him back if you want. Well, right now, we'll take a break. Stay with us, please.